You're the one, yes. Not like the scabs that exited the shuttle with you. You radiate power, Lord. I bow before you. I serve Lord Barriss. He sent me to meet his new apprentice, and I made sure I was here on time. I certainly did, yes indeed.
Barriss should have met me himself.
It is not my place to question the master. I'm just a slave who owes his every breath to the tolerance of Lord Barriss. He said to introduce you to Dromund Kaas, and I take that seriously.
Your breathing is now dependent on my tolerance as well.
Yes, my lord. I exist by your good grace. Lord Barriss ordered me to encourage you to explore Kaas City before reporting to him. Imperials maintain the order, but they won't bother you. When you're ready, Lord Barriss will meet you in his personal chambers. You will tell Lord Barriss I was good? Yes? That I served well?
Just get out of my sight.
Have I done something to offend? How may I make amends, Lord?
Don't make me repeat myself.
I see I've overstayed my welcome. I hope to be of service again. Goodbye.
Wow, you showed remarkable restraint with him.
And exactly why would that be hard to believe?
No reason. Forget I said anything.
Enjoy your stay.
Force is a weapon. I will show you how to wield it.
Not a minute too soon. Your timing is impeccable.
Did it just get considerably colder?
I see you decided to keep the slave. I hope she amuses you. I trust you've been acquainting yourself with your new environs. Did my minion point you in the right direction?
His pointer finger was a bit twitchy.
A byproduct of constantly fearing for his life. But it keeps him in line, doing the trivial tasks that need tending to. Your responsibilities will mandate contact with my various minions. Meet my directives, and you may do as you will to anyone you encounter, adversary or ally.
You can trust that I'll use good judgment, Master.
I have painstakingly built a vast network of spies and operatives embedded throughout the Sith, Republic, and Jedi alike. I have fingers, eyes, and ears everywhere.
You've successfully infiltrated the Jedi Order.
Yes, my operatives are completely undetected, and I wish to keep it that way. I track our enemy, weakening and influencing them from within, waiting to strike. You're my enforcer, deployed to protect my interests, intimidate my rivals, and destroy my enemies. It's time for your tenure to begin.
A military starship is touching down at the Kos City cargo port, delivering a vitally important prisoner to me.
You will meet Commander Lanklin at Docking Bay 12 and make sure he and his men successfully offload this prisoner.
If you're sending me, you must be expecting trouble.
We must always assume that we are being plotted against, especially when the stakes are high.
The importance of this prisoner cannot be overstated. Go to the cargo port now and stay sharp. You are dismissed.
All right, man, let's hurry up and get this hunk of carbonite to its owner.
Hey, Captain Olivius. Boo.
Oh, I didn't see you enter. Lord Barriss didn't need to send a welcoming party.
You're lucky I'm not an enemy, or you'd all be dead.
Forgive me, my lord, but this is the capital world of the Empire. My men and I have performed much more dangerous duties for Lord Barriss. The prisoner is frozen in carbonite, so he's not a flight risk. And this is friendly territory. Surely we're safe here.
There is no such thing as friendly territory.
No offense, my lord. That brand of paranoia may work for Lord Barriss, but I don't subscribe to it.
Which one of your men takes over after I kill you?
Please, my lord. There's no need for talk like that. I heed your point. Let's get this oversized block of ice to your master.
Not so fast. My master ordered that block of ice. So step away from the carbonite man and no one ends up in a grave.
Your master is going to be disappointed.
Perhaps I didn't make myself plainly clear. I'm here to relieve you of your burden. Whether that includes your own lives as well is up to you.
Looky, looky. If it ain't Slestak, your master be wanting the froze man to her. Too bad for you. It mine.
You two know each other?
To know Tumar is to hate Tumar.
That go true for you too, Slestak. If you don't flee, this be like killing two stone with one bird.
I'm such a fool. I'll never doubt Lord Barriss again. What do we do?
Don't panic.
On their own, Tumar and his lackeys wouldn't be much of a fight.
You mouth always get you in trouble, Slestak. It about to chew off more than it can bite.
You're going to take that, Slestak?
Very amusing. I do relish the opportunity to rid the world of Tumar and his drones. So I'll be with you presently, Instigator.
Come on, boys. We smash the talk from Slestak's big mouth now!
Well done. While they fight, my men and I will deliver the prisoner to Lord Barriss. Thank you for buying us time, my lord.
Franklin informed me of the ambush at the cargo port. Apparently there are more eyes on us than even I thought.
I have felt a disturbance in the Force. It leaves doom imprinted on my dreams. A grave and mysterious threat that could bring down my entire power base. This frozen man is a top Republic agent captured while investigating my most deeply embedded spy on Nar Shaddaa. One of my invisibles. The Force grants me a vision of doom. And immediately, my untraceable spy, who has left no footprints, no trail, is almost exposed. It makes me furious.
Maybe your spy wasn't so invisible after all.
Do not presume to tell me my business. There's no profit in it. I must learn what tipped off the Republic agent. He is the key to uncovering the nature of this threat.
Now, while I fall the prisoner and painfully siphon every morsel of information I can from him, I have some concerns that require your special talents.
I'd like to stay and watch the torture, my lord.
Yuck. Please, no.
You can watch me torture the next prisoner. Go to the Imperial post in the jungles outside the city. Commander Pritch is stationed there. He has a seek and destroy task for you.
I don't take orders from lackeys.
Pritch is merely relaying information, apprentice. I must tend to the torturing of this miserable Republic agent. Waste no time. I have more for you to do once this is complete. You are dismissed.
Exactly as reported. A degree 6 revolt, population equivalent to the Duros uprising on Xilior. Subjects occupy a moderate radius of jungle. Good. Good. Welcome, apprentice. Your timing couldn't be better. I am Lord Drowl. When the Empire encounters resistance on its conquered worlds, they call me. I'm here to end the slave uprising on Drummond Cass.
I wasn't aware there was a slave revolt going on.
Very soon there won't be. You can assist me in ending it. Situation is this. A Sith Lord was constructing a colossal statue of himself in the jungle. His slaves revolted and armed themselves. The Colossus remains unfinished and well-armed slaves now control the jungle. An embarrassment for the Empire, but an opportunity for me.
I don't appreciate dramatic pauses.
Excited? Good. This is a chance to refine the Empire's methods of suppressing rebellion. I'm testing a toxic weapon, a poison called Quell. Its victims experience a prolonged state of agonizing pain before finally dying. The victim's allies are so horrified by Quell's effects, they lose their wills to resist. At least that's what I intend to prove.
That is deeply disturbing.
That's one of the things I love best about it. I need someone to introduce a controlled amount of Quell into the slave's water supply so that I can determine the proper dosage. Work is dangerous. There will be armed slaves everywhere. But your success will be well rewarded. What do you say?
I prefer to deal death more directly to my opponents.
My methods extend well beyond the lightsaber's reach, my friend. Expand your horizons. My assistant, Sergeant Slerin, will recommend the correct dosage of Quell and give you a supply. See him at the research tent.
If I know Lord Drowl's tastes, which unfortunately I do, he sent you for the Quell toxin.
I'm helping him put down the slave revolt.
Do you truly understand what he's asked you to do? What if I told you this experiment is pointless? That past studies have shown increased suffering has no impact on the speed of surrender? This has nothing to do with accelerating the end of a rebellion. Lord Drowl simply takes perverse thrill in gratuitous suffering.
I'm sure Lord Drowl wouldn't appreciate these comments.
Don't get me wrong, Lord Drowl is very good at what he does, but he lets his personal bents impede our efficiency. I want this assignment over with. The faster this rebellion ends, the faster I'll be reassigned to more important work. Serving Lord Drowl's bloodlust has stunted my career. If not for his inefficiency, I'd be a captain by now.
Still just be a meaningless Imperial drone.
Perhaps, but a better paid Imperial drone, with more authority. Lord Drowl's dosage of Quell toxin will have slaves writhing in agony for pointless weeks, during which this area will remain volatile. I've prepared a dose that will kill the slaves efficiently, which is better for the Empire and for me. Will you deliver my dosage instead?
Let's end this revolt efficiently and kill off these renegades.
Wonderful. It's the right thing for everyone. Well, almost everyone. I'll give you a maximum dose of Quell toxin. Inject it into the slave camp's water filtration systems and see Lord Drowl afterward.
Thank you.
Commander Pritch at your service, my lord. Lord Barriss informed me you'd be paying us a visit. I'm prepared to offer full assistance.
Aren't you a good little soldier?
Lord Barriss has always found me, Sir Lord. Permit me to update you on the situation here. There's been much unrest in these parts recently, my lord, capped off by a violent slave revolt that has the surrounding jungles overrun with armed slaves.
You can't deal with upstart slaves.
The slaves have been giving the forces sent to deal with them fits. I'm not part of that duty, my lord.
What no one knows is that Lord Barriss orchestrated the insurgents to disrupt one of his rivals, and he wants his involvement kept secret. Now the slave captains who led the revolt are threatening to expose Barriss's involvement unless they receive more potent weapons.
Slaves. They're never satisfied.
I'd just be happy if you took the stupid shock collar off.
I'll take it under advisement.
I see you know how to handle slaves, my lord. You think they know better than to blackmail a Sith Lord. Lord Barriss wants you to kill enough of the blackmailing slave captains to make the others lose their resolve.
Violence is not always the answer.
Well, I suppose. Many of these slave captains are former criminals with ties to the underworld. In fact, some have been selling their fellow slaves to the black market. If their followers found out, they'd be furious. If I had proof that they're selling their own people back into slavery, I could blackmail the slave captains to stop blackmailing Lord Barriss.
What kind of proof?
I bet they keep records of their transactions. If you rifle the slave captains' footlockers and find proof, I'll do what I can to use it against them.
It's worth a try.
However you want to deal with it, my lord. Slave captains have their home base around the unfinished Colossus. I'll await any proof you salvage from the slave captain's belongings.
Just when you thought there weren't enough big statues on this planet.
My lord, you're back. Did you find sufficient proof that the slave captains are selling their people back into slavery?
The slave captains kept logbooks.
Most impressive, my lord. I can see why Lord Barriss has such faith in you. Now I can threaten to expose the truth. If the slave captains don't want to be torn limb from limb, they'll stop blackmailing Lord Barriss. I must say, my lord, it's been inspiring watching you work.
Prostrate yourself elsewhere, Imperial.
I'm sorry if I've angered you. I'll inform Lord Barriss that the situation has been handled.
I don't understand why it didn't work. I was meticulous with my measurements.
Those slaves must be more fragile than I thought. The Quellu put in their water supply is killing them outright.
The shock of instant death will throw the slaves off balance.
Shock? I'm not interested in such brute force. All my research is now useless. Oh well. You did as I asked, and your payment was not contingent on the results.
Here, Take your credits and go.
I have a great deal of thinking to do.
I don't care what you do. Break my bones, burn my flesh. I'll tell you nothing.
I will not be denied.
Go spit, you monster!
I didn't know bodies could bend like that. I think I'm gonna be sick.
Spare yourself. You shouldn't have to see this.
Ah, apprentice, you've returned. Commander Pritch confirmed that the slaves have been silenced. Good. I'm still trying to extract the information I crave from this Republic agent. He's much more resilient than anticipated.
I thought you said you were good at this.
Now is not a good time to test me, apprentice. Even as I brutalize him, I twist the Force to keep him alive and feeling every sensation.
That is the cruelest thing I've ever heard.
I have another important task for you. It involves a renegade Sith Lord named Grathen, a particularly bothersome thorn in my side. Meet with my apprentice, Dreykul Ball. He's my covert operative in Gratham's compound. Ball claims to have made a key discovery.
I thought I might be your only apprentice. That makes Baal my rival.
Try to tolerate him long enough to get the details and conclude your business there. Gratham's presence is useful to me, so I don't want him killed, just crippled. Find out what Ball has discovered and do exactly as he instructs.
Is your other apprentice above me in the pecking order?
I'm sure he views himself as your better. But he has merely been here longer. Oh, then, Republic wretch, where were we? Oh, yes. Tell me what I wish to know.
You must be the operative Lord Barriss sent. I thought he'd choose a stealthy assassin, not some senseless savage.
Watch who you're calling a savage.
You're not talking to one of Barriss' Imperial peons. I'll be working for Lord Barriss long after you've worn out your welcome.
Care to put that theory to the test?
We've got business to handle. With the entire complex roused, we'll have to get in each other's faces another time. Now listen. Lord Grathen is a rogue Sith who boldly defies the Dark Council. Locked away here, he's been untouchable. Lord Barriss wants to let Grathen know he can be reached. And after a year undercover, I've discovered the way. Lord Grathen has a son.
Maybe in another year you can find out his shoe size.
He wears boots, not shoes, smartmouth. I was assigned to find Grathen's weakness. He's kept his son a secret in order to protect him from his enemies. Grathen would be devastated if his only child and heir was dead. That would send a message.
Won't killing his son just make Grathen mad?
Lord Barriss seeks to imbalance Grathen, make him sloppy. Grathen's kid is nearly 20 and strong with the Force. He's been trained in the ways of the Sith since birth. You'll have your hands full.
I highly doubt it.
All right. Maybe underestimating your foes works for you. Grathen's away on business. I managed to hack a special spike that will get you inside his private quarters. But first you're going to have to knock out Grathen's surveillance station so you aren't seen entering the quarters.
What do I care if I'm observed?
The surveillance system is also a sophisticated defense network. If you don't destroy the system before entering the private chambers, you'll never make it. All you have to do is locate the monitoring stations around the compound and, well, stick your lightsaber in them. Think you can handle that, brute?
Keep calling me names, Baal. You're playing with fire.
Is it so easy to get under your skin? That's all then. Destroy the monitoring stations, then get inside Grathen's private quarters. The son's name is Beelzlit. Find him and end him. I'll meet you back here when you're done. Try not to screw up.
I kinda like his attitude.
Mother, a stranger approaches.
You don't know the half of it, kid.
I am Sylvanta Grathen. How dare you enter my son's room uninvited? Who are you?
I am Doom.
You'll find I'm not so easily intimidated. My son is still an acolyte, but I am Sith. Beelzlet, take cover.
No, Mother! I stand at your side! Attack!
You think you scare me?
Enough. It's clear we are not your match. If we're to die, I must know. What have we done to deserve death?
It's not personal.
If not, then perhaps you'll entertain another option. You have fought your way into the inner sanctum of a powerful Sith Lord stronghold. You are a breath away from the Master himself. Spare us, and I'll help you destroy Lord Grathen instead.
You want me to kill your husband? Aren't you the dutiful wife?
I married Lord Grathen for power. It was a means to an end. Now I want out. I'm strong, but can't touch my husband. How long I've waited for someone to end his oppressive rule.
You have my attention.
A wicked plan is taking shape. Long ago, my husband was nearly beheaded. Now he cannot exist without his helmeted mask. Everyone knows this. Kill Lord Grathen. My son will wear the mask and assume his mantle. He'll publicly rant that his son was murdered. No one will be the wiser.
What's in it for me?
In addition to appearing successful in your task, I'll reward you in either credits or an item of power. Your choice.
I prefer a powerful item.
Excellent. You won't regret it. Lord Grathen deserves to die. With this pass card, you may enter Lord Grathen's secret chamber. You'll find him there. After you've ended Lord Grathen's miserable existence, bring his masked helmet to me.
Be sure there are no surprises when I return.
I'm certainly not interested in angering someone as lethal as you. Besides, you're doing me a great service. Be wary of Lord Grathen. There are few as attuned to the dark side as he.
I don't think I like the sound of that.
My uninvited guest finally arrives. Your feelings betray you, youngster. I sensed your murderous intentions the moment you entered my sanctum. What's more, your unshielded mind has revealed your accomplice, my loving wife.
She sends her love?
Selvanta is a user, child. She's obsessed with power. It's one of the things that attracted me to her. But it's outgrown its amusement. I am death itself, child. Come embrace the darkness.
I'm going to haunt you.
I sensed my husband's death. Lord Grathen is no more. What pleasure to think he suffered.
He didn't enjoy it. He screamed like a stuck cathound.
Mother, what does this mean? Am I truly to become the master of this house?
You will wear his mask and assume his identity. But you are not yet ready to rule, my dear. The voice will be yours, but the words will be mine.
I have longed for my father's death and the chance to claim his power.
Yes, This is a great day. You have served us well, my new friend.
Perhaps you could show your appreciation in a more personal manner.
Aren't you the rogue? You freed me from an inconvenient husband and put me in control of this house. Let me show you my appreciation. In private.
Whoa! Wait a minute. You're not seriously considering this. You have really terrible taste in women.
Don't be such a child.
Age has nothing to do with good taste. But do what you have to.
Now that we've cleared that up, all this talk is making me impatient. Beelzlet, find something to do, will you? Your mother needs some privacy.
Yes, Mother.
And are you going to dismiss your Twi'lek?
She never leaves my side.
You've got to be kidding me.
Well, well, well. Whatever you say. It's your party. Of all the things I've endured to gain power, this was one of the least unpleasant. You are always welcome in my chamber, friend.
Keep the door unlocked.
Where would the fun be in that? Now leave me. I have much to do now that I control House Graffen.
I'm surprised you survived. So is it done? Is Grathan's son dead?
You're a condescending windbag, Baal.
It's pretty easy to push your buttons, Brute. Doesn't say much for Grathan's security forces if a clumsy clod like you was able to bang into his private chamber and off his son.
I find your empty chatter amusing.
You'll find my lightsaber a bit sobering. Killing the murderer of Grathan's son will solidify my cover here. Barriss can replace you easily.
Aren't you the scoundrel?
You don't know the half of it. Though I'm more than capable of facing you alone, a smart man uses every advantage. And I am a smart man.
Intruder! The intruder is here! Everyone to me! Attack!
Nice lungs you got there.
Mind your tongue, or I will cut it out!
Okay, I'm officially scared.
This is impossible. An unknown power must be shielding this man, which only confirms my suspicions. This Republic agent is the key to unlocking the threat we face. I must harness my rage and frustration. They will lead me to an answer!
Trust your feelings, Master.
The minion advises the Master. Very good. You demonstrate your progress. And the word has spread that Lord Grathan is incensed at the slaying of his secret son. I take it that was your handiwork?
After dealing with his son, I stayed to socialize with Lady Grathan. An added humiliation for him.
Ah, my young apprentice, you have just cheered me up. I haven't heard from Dreykul Ball, my agent in Grathan's camp. He's missed a scheduled communication. Let me guess. He gave you trouble, did he?
He left me no choice, Master. I had to kill him.
No matter. He fulfilled his primary purpose. Every Sith must attempt to orchestrate his own promotion. Now, back to my prisoner. There's one last possibility to break him. I thought it impossible, but perhaps there's a small chance you could pull it off. Over a millennium past, the Emperor claimed Drummond Kaas and made the Dark Temple the epicenter of Dark Force energy. In the bowels of the temple, he conducted horrifying experiments that drained the knowledge and life essence from all the greatest Sith lords of the time.
Sounds like my kind of guy.
I'm sure that he would be relieved to hear that you approve. The Emperor created a device called the Ravager that ate his victims' minds and delivered to him their greatest secrets. No one could withstand the Ravager's intrusion. Even the strongest Sith lords of the Empire confessed whatever the Emperor craved.
I'm sure the Emperor has the best toys.
I wouldn't call the Ravager a toy, Apprentice. It's not to be taken lightly. The Emperor keeps the Ravager hidden in the Dark Temple, which has, in his absence, become a death trap. There's a good chance the horrors that await you will be too severe. But it's worth your life to me. The legends describe a secret chamber in the depths of the Dark Temple where the Ravager was encased. You'll know the device by its inscription. Be swift, Apprentice.